Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Vincent Tan speaking. This time, I'm going to show you how to install the TNV. This sharing divides into these five parts. I have the corresponding video linkages at the below description area just for your reference. Moreover, I also provide the correct subtitle. Don't forget to turn it on if you need. Wire connection.
And first is to do the power cable wiring. Basically, you can just follow the circuit diagram from owner's manual to finish it is okay. So in this cases, you can find it for either outdoor unit and any indoor unit, there must be a circuit breaker. The purpose of it is to avoid or to prevent the risk of the leakage current. And also you can also find it, there is a total circuit breaker for the indoor units and outdoor units. And this is the circuit breaker. And as for the outdoor unit and indoor unit, just follow the diagram to do the power cable. It's okay.
First of all, how to do the wiring? From this diagram, you can find that this black color, this line is the copper tube. It just connects the outdoor units and the indoor units. And this blue wire, it is the communication cable. It is connected on the D1, D2. Series connected from top to tail. And also we command at the last indoor unit to wire the match resistor, this one. And for the wire controller, just from this case, this one, number one and number two, it is one wire controller to control one indoor unit and two wire controllers to control the same indoor unit. We also support one wire controller to control this number three multi indoor units and also two wire controllers to control multi indoor units. And this multi, the maximum is 16. And the wiring is you can just put all the H1, H2, the series connect together, then to the wire controller is okay. As for the communication cable, we recommend this huge stick pair instead of these regular two wires. Just we need to guarantee the communication. You can see there is a shoe here. This slide displays how to do the wiring on the outdoor unit. And when you open the panel, you will see this electrical box. And just open this box, you will see here is for the power cable L123 and the earthing. Earthing here, L123. And also this one, this D1, D2 is for the communication to the indoor units or the other outdoor units. And this G1, G2 is for the centralized control.
And here is the detail how to do the wiring. And first is the system adopt the CAN communication, which in the control system, this can achieve or to adjusting. And for the detail, you wiring cross match is available, which means for example, you just connect D1, D2. For this one, you don't need to memorize the colors of the wire. You can just make it readily. It's okay. And also the same for the H1, H2, and G1, G2. You don't need to memorize the color, just do the wiring, it's okay. And as for the wire itself, we don't require the huge stick pair. But if there are too much EMI, which is the electromagnetic interference, here is the countermeasures. First is apply the STP between the wire controller and indoor units and outdoor units. This is the first step. And the next step is the last indoor unit, it should wire with the match resistor. And as for the wire requirement, it should is this, either for the D1, D2 or H1, H2. The difference is just the length.
Also, also support to control the VRF from your smartphone. Here we call it T-Cloud, which is rely on this T-Cloud module. And where to install? It is on the HIPPOM system. You need to install, which is to pump to the CN11 of the indoor unit. Here for the old PCB, and here is for the other kind of the PCB. As for the heat recovery system, also CN11, but this time we make it to be this mode exchanger, also called branch box.
For the wiring, please never mix the D1 D2 with H1 H2. And the reason is that for the D1 D2, it is DC 5 volt, but H1 H2 is a HBS system. It is DC 12 volt. If you mix them for a long time, which means D1 D2 connected to H1 H2, which means the system will output DC 12 volt into the D1 D2. And if it lasts for a long time, maybe 1 or 2 days, it will damage the main board just like this. You can find it, there's cases in China. We just find that if we misconnect the D1 D2 with H1 H2, it will make this to be damaged. The whole outdoor unit main board become malfunction. The reason is this resistor burn. And to replace this one, we need to replace the whole outdoor unit PCB. So in this is also indicates how to do the wiring. D1 D2 is separated to G1 G2 and H1 H2. And also don't forget this one. This action resistor. It is 120 ohm at the last indoor unit.
That's all for this sharing. If you still have any other question or any other suggestion, feel free to send me to my email address. Meanwhile, you can also scan this QR code to access the sharing. Hasta la próxima. Suerte va. Mata. Conto.